2020 fucking sucks dick.
No shit.
Almost all my concerts were cancelled. I wanted to do some vlog videos about my trips, but the fucking virus just cancelled it. Everybody in Walmart were fighting for some toilet paper. And there's the new KFC console coming pretty soon. Huh? Is that even true, Evil Willow?
Yeah. Why would I mention it in the text?
Huh. That's interesting. If we don't count all of this shitty stuff that happened in the year, 2020 has been a great year for the music and video game community. The Benny CDC reunited after 6 years of absence, and they even made their most sold album, Power Up. And it was also the beginning of livestream shows. But for me as a metalhead, livestream shows fucking sucks. I just want to go back in the old days where we can see the actual band. Just please. But for the video game community, oh my gosh, there was a lot of fucking games. And there was a lot of great video games. And no, The Last of Us Part 2 doesn't count as a good game. To end this shitty year, aka 2020, I wanted to do a video about my 8 favorite video games of 2020. What's up everyone, it's me your boy Willow, and today I'm gonna tell you my 8 favorite video games of 2020. Now let's jump right into it. Persona 4 is not like any RPGs that you can imagine. Because in this game, random shit happens. Let me give you an example. Like, imagine, today is a Monday afternoon, and you're hanging out with your friends at McDonald's, and you're like, hey, this is the best day ever. And then what happened in the next day? Surprise, surprise, a fucking murder! So you need to go to the mall because your TV is not that big, and then a random waifu appears! This is totally what I love about Persona 4, any day is a surprise. But also there's... really great battle mechanics. No seriously, the battles are really unique. When you're fighting versus a shadow, you have a mechanic called Persona. Personas are spiritual cards who can be transformed as, what I love to call them, stands. And they do twice the damage of your character. But seriously, I really love this game. I wonder if I can finish it pretty soon.
Son of a bitch!
Fun fact about this game, everyone that I know who bought the game were saying stuff that is basically a knockoff of Star Wars Force Unleashed. Well, guess what, ladies and gentlemen? They were wrong. Cause you see, in Force Unleashed, every quest are the same. You just fight stormtroopers, fighting Jedis, and there is no timeline. But in the other end, Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order happens in the same timeline as Rogue One. And also the battle mechanic is really fun and easy to use. But also the game, oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. And sometimes when you're stuck in puzzle areas, BD-1 is always there for you. And that's really useful. But seriously, Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order is by far the most unique Star Wars game that I ever played. When I think about remakes, I think about The Legend of Zelda Link Awakening on the Switch. Like seriously, how did we get from the Game Boy era to the Switch version? If we don't count all of these changes, the gameplay never actually changed. But however, there's a new mechanic in the game called creating your own dungeon. But comparing with Super Mario Maker is pretty shitty. But still, Link's Awakening will always be my favorite remake video game.
What the fuck are you looking at?
You might seen the review that I made about this game, but I just need to come back to it one last time. Like I just said, the game is basically a mix of Castlevania and Mega Man. And instead of hitting enemies with your weapon just like in Mega Man, there's a lot of attacks you can do. You can wall jump, sprint on enemies. Long story short, you can do a lot of options in this game. And I will really love to replay it on stream though.
Wait, what the fuck? Are you special or something, Will? You love a game with a lot of glitches? What is wrong with you?
Listen, Evo Willow, I haven't finished talking. Just listen. I know there's a lot of insane glitches in Cyberpunk, but listen, I've played Skyrim and they have the same problem. But even though this game have a lot of problems, Cyberpunk 2077 is one of my favorite games of all time. The graphics are insanely beautiful. Any choices that you do depends on the story. Jackie and Johnny Silverhand are really funny. And also, the driving mechanic is not that bad. And before you say stuff like, "But the driving mechanic is really shitty, Will." Well, I have one thing to say to you. Try Roger Rabbit and talk to me later. Guys, I had to admit something. 2020 was a really hard year. When I started my YouTube career, I knew it was going to be a really hard job. I had to make videos as quick as possible. And I was too busy with online classes. It was too much pressure for me. But then, Nintendo just gave us a game that saved me. And I had the ability to play with my friends again. And you might probably say, "Whoa, what is the best game of the year?"
Well, it's Animal Crossing, baby! Woo! Yeah!
Hey guys, it's me, Will. I just wanted to end the year by showing you my art progress because, yes, I draw a lot. And some of my friends helped me to progress my art style. Also, I used to draw since I was 3 years old. As you can see in the picture, I first drew my character in March 2016. And then we move on 2017. In that time, I was trying to draw my character into an anime art style. And as you can see, it's pretty awful. And let's go in 2018. It was in the time when my parents gave me a graphic tablet for my birthday. And also it was the first time that I used Photoshop and Krita. Now let's go in 2019 with a much cooler art style. I just love that in the picture it looks like I drew it on paper, but it's not. And also it was way before I do anatomy. And now let's go on the shitty year 2020. It was in the time when Matt showed me how to color my art. But overall, it's not that bad. And now let's go in 2021, where I actually made my character more realistic and more alive. And I think I just found an art style that actually fits with me. My three resolutions of 2021 are getting better at art, going to see a lot of metal shows, and getting 69 subs for my face reveal. And to conclude all of that, I wanna say, 2020 is a shitty year. I hope 2021 will be the best year of our lives. And I wanna say, stay healthy everyone, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!